Hi all, welcome to Instrumentation Academy. In this video, we will be reading a real plant p&Id. This is the second part of our video, how to read a p&Id. In the first part, we had discussed about the symbols and legends used in p&Id. Link of that video is provided in the description box. Keep in mind that reading and understanding p&Id is a core topic of instrumentation. Any instrumentation engineer or technician should know this stuff before they enter any plant as a team member. A process plant will have a number of similar process instruments and a bunch of p&Id drawings. If a technician has to find a p&Id drawing associated with a particular instrument, then he has to note down the tag number of that particular instrument and check a document called instrument index to get the exact p&Id number associated with that instrument. Instrument index. Instrument index is a document containing list of instruments within a plant. Instrument index shall include tag number of all physical instruments and pseudo instruments like DCS indications. This is a typical instrument index document. This gives us information about tag number, instrument type, service and location of instruments and corresponding p&Id number. Now we have the exact p&Id drawing corresponding to the particular instrument with us. The first page of p&Id is naturally the cover page. The second page is the index sheet. Index sheet of p&Id gives us an idea about the drawing number, description of p&Id, and the revision number of the drawing. The first drawing made is represented as R0. Any change made in the drawing from R0 is represented as R1. Respectively, the further changes are represented as R2, R3, and so on. Next sheet is p&Id symbology legend. This sheet gives us an idea about almost all the symbols and abbreviations used in this p&Id. This is a typical p&Id. P&Id drawing has mainly three parts. The first is title and revision block. Second one is notes block and the third part is drawing and description block. Now let us see each block in detail. Title and revision block. This block contains title of P&Id drawing, drawing number, company details and revision details. The notes block. This block explains any special symbols and conventions used on drawing. It also gives us information which is necessary to understand the drawing. Now the last block is drawing and description block. This block includes the p&Id drawing and its necessary descriptions. Now I will explain how to read this p&Id. This is a process flow tag which shows from where this pipeline is coming from and the previous p&Id number. From this tag, we can understand that this pipe is coming from scrapper launcher. In this p&Id, at the end of the process flow tag, we can see the line number which gives us the details about size, purpose, and material classification of this pipeline, which we have already discussed in our previous video. The main line divides into two streams through a T-joint. As flow T is mentioned here, it is understood that a special type of fitting called flow T is used in this pipeline. Any special type of fittings used will be clearly mentioned like this in a p&Id. Now we follow this main stream. Here we can see a ball valve XOV201U in between the pipelines. Below this ball valve symbol, it is written as note 9 and 10. To know what note 9 and 10 is, we have to check the notes block which we had mentioned earlier. When you see a note like this near to any instrument, you have to check the note block to get more idea about that instrument. Now we can see that the valve is fitted with the limit switches ZSL and ZSH. This limit switches shows the open and closed status of the valve. ZLL and ZLH shows the corresponding running lights in local panel and control room. Now when we see the actuator of the valve XOV, we can understand that the valve is a pneumatic valve as pneumatic lines are entering the valve. When we follow this pneumatic lines, we can see two solenoid valves from where the pneumatic lines are coming. As close is mentioned near to XSV201A solenoid valve, this valve is used to close the XOV valve. As open is mentioned near to XSV201B solenoid valve, this valve is used to open the XOV valve. Both the solenoid valves are connected to a differential pressure switch PDSH through an interlock logic which determines when to open or close the XOV valve. Differential pressure switch is a device which utilizes a differential pressure to activate an electric switch. It is used to sense pressure difference between two points in a system. When we closely watch the differential pressure switch, we can see that two pneumatic lines are connected to it. The differential pressure between the upstream and downstream of the XOV valve is used to activate the interlock, which determines whether to open or close the XOV valve. The valve is set to close when the rate of upstream or downstream pressure drop reaches a predetermined value. PDAH is indicator alarm light in panel which indicates that differential pressure across XOV is high. By this we come to the end of this video. Hope you got an idea about how to read a p&Id. If you like this video, please support us by subscribing our channel. Thank you.